to order. 6:30, we'll start the meeting. Is it open? Folks get in?
It's open. If not, they'll rap on it.
But that's not technically open.
It's technically adequate.
David Hefkin here, Chris Lathrop. Airport Commission meeting. Okay, we'll put you in roll after once you get here, okay? Thanks, sure, bye-bye. That was him, he said he's running a little late, but he'll be here. So when he gets here, we'll just call him in. John Mitchell, here. Lou Radecki.
Here.
Larry Koch.
Here.
Okay. Should I read the statement?
Yes.
Okay. In regards to public comment, please limit your time to a maximum of 3 minutes and be respectful to all who are in attendance of this meeting. While speaking to the commission members, will not engage in discussion with the person who is talking to the commissioners. If you'd like to have your concerns discussed, please submit them in writing to the Airport Commission Chairman, myself, at AmericanRentalsLLC@gmail.com to have them included, possibly in a future meeting agenda. We are here to conduct airport business, and the commission will not answer questions inside the meeting. That's the public comment. None written down, nothing taken. Correspondence.
Since it wasn't a regular meeting, we're really not on the agenda.
Are we reading the wrong one then? I'm sorry. Let me back up. Public comment, correspondence, reports none, operations, no, okay. Sorry, my mistake.
It's okay.
I should have read all the way down. Update on stormwater runoff hangar projects by myself. Nothing. Just the government moves at snail's pace. New business. Discuss amend airport operations budget. Am I still in the wrong one?
Yeah, you're still in the wrong one.
What the?
Throw it away.
February 6th.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Get what you pay for.
Okay. Old business. Take action on T-hanger and tie-down leases. And discuss and take action on amending hangar leases. Did everybody get a chance to read? Does anybody want a copy?
No, I read mine, okay.
I read it.
Do I have a motion to approve?
Well, do you have a copy of these?
Yes, I don't know. Lou, did
yeah,
I give you
that? Not yet. This is a hangar.
Dave,
hey,
we don't approve the minutes from last meeting now?
Yeah.
Not on there.
And we have to approve the meeting from, we have to approve that January 30th. January 30th.
Did I miss
this
that?
One. This no, one right here. Approve the January 30th minutes.
Oh, no, I didn't miss
oh,
that.
No, the fifth. Yeah. Huh?
Oh, we have here.
Yeah.
No, forget that. I'm not perfect.
That's January 30th.
Okay. Yes.
January 30th minutes need to be approved.
Do I have a motion
so
to?
So moved.
Well, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Who is this? Someone second it?
Yeah, who seconded it?
I'll second it.
John Mitchell.
Okay. Now we go down.
Moving along.
Down to the leases.
Well, what's the term of the lease?
It was 25 years for the hangars.
Back up. Which one are you talking about? The hangars are regular.
Hangar area lease.
That was 25. And they were both adjusted every other year, 5% maximum.
Yeah, okay.
And we added the operations of the airport in there, which we had discussed last time, what the airport is responsible for. And then we also changed the verbiage that said that if we had to do any lighting, that would be at the airport cost. That was in there.
Yeah.
And then the The other one was the T-hanger, was 3-year, up to 5% every other year, which is what we had discussed, and all those other things in there. The only thing is, I'd like to talk about, we had talked about the sublet. I don't have a problem with subletting, but I think it says on there, with approval. What do you think about the approval of it? I mean, if the T-hanger's done.
Yeah. Well, that would be sort of up to Bob, but I would say that good guidance would be it's an airplane that's actively being flown at all.
And they need to know what the terms are of what is stored in.
Right. So, I don't know, Lou, what do you think about, I mean, because to take it out without having something, that's the only thing that kind of bothers me a little bit.
So because it takes away the buddies on a hangar.
Like. Well, what could happen is you can have like a perpetual hangar that's like perpetually changing hands, and we don't even
know who's in it.
No, it's supposed to be approved by Bob, though.
Well, but if we take that clause out,
if we take it
which
out,
was what we had discussed one other time, you know, to
the airport manager needs to know who is leasing.
No, the T-hanger is.
So what's the difference between a rental? If I go to Florida and rent my hangar for the winter, or somebody.
Good point.
So I don't know. What is it?
Well, a sublet would be someone that has a lease that you're granting the lease.
You're letting someone else use your hangar for.
But that would
payments.
Be rental, though. That would be a rental, and then you're still responsible for their actions.
And sublet.
Well, if you sublet, does that mean that there has to be payment? Paper exchange?
Well, I think like John had brought up that if he buys a hangar and he wants to keep his hangar for a while just to make sure, and you would sublet it to somebody, his T-hanger, before he gives it up. That's subletting.
Yeah, but would you write them a lease?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it would have everything that's in
that
there.
That would be a sublet as opposed to you deciding to go south for. What's the difference?
Well, the person that would be subleasing or whatever would should have to sign the lease agreement.
Wait a minute, hold it back up. Are you talking about the T-hanger?
Yes. T-hanger. This is just T-hanger.
You don't lease the T-hanger, you rent
it. Oh, you rent it.
You rent the T-hanger.
Yeah, right.
So is that lease assignable?
I mean, it says lease in here, but it says it is a rent.
Right, but it was brought up to possibly allow that. So I just wanted to discuss that.
I don't see any. If I was renting a T-hanger, I don't see any reason why I'd want to rent it to somebody else.
Well, just to hold your place. What if you took off for a year? Traveled the world like you do.
But then how would you know who's in there if you can't get in touch with the person, even though the T-hanger leasee is ultimately responsible? Shouldn't we know who's in there?
Yeah, the manager still should know.
Manager should know who's there.
So how do you write that then? How do you?
With manager's approval, it says with manager's approval, finally the manager's going to know who's in there. Then.
There has to be an agreement between whoever's leasing it and the person that would be subleasing. There'd have to be agreement between them, and he would have to know who the person is that's in there.
How do we put that verbiage for?
Where does that put us if someone is in default?
So if John's in default as a primary.
Right, but there's another airplane in there that you can't pull out.
John's ultimately responsible for our payment, so if it's he would be the one.
I know, but you know, in the
for
apartments, then you'd have a squatter. So then if all of a sudden John is in Florida and something happens and they're having a beer party in there or whatever, that's a lease violation. You know, yes, John's responsible, but then how do you get rid of somebody or give them a lease violation? Or let's say that John leaves and then they start storing cars in there. Then it goes against the feds for aeronautical use. Because then there's no mechanism for approval, which I think it should have the approval, if somebody other than you is in
right there. Now, if Bob, just in this case, because Bob's really angry, if Bob goes, who's in there, and if that other person in there signed the same agreement, they're bound with the same rules as everybody else.
Yeah, and who's the lease?
Well, if it's his, has the
lease,
he is ultimately, the buck stops with him because he has the primary lease. But he should know who is leasing it if it is sold.
So how do we put that verbiage?
Well, why don't we say pre-approved?
Well, once you have a lease transfer clause in there now, you've read it, right?
Yes.
Everybody that's rented a T hanger since their inception is still renting. It's never come up.
No, well, I think it's going to be a very rare situation anyhow. I think they're spending too much time on it.
Well,
it's unlikely to happen.
Take it out of there. Just strike it out of there.
Why don't, what we should do is make it simple, and if somebody wants to do that or comes before us, I don't see that happening anyhow.
You want to change that on there so I can have that ready to go to the world?
I would say we would...
Just run a line through it, take it out.
I would say do it if there is a need for it.
Why don't we just say lease transfer, not allowed, period.
Okay, that's fine with me.
Yeah,
okay.
Not allowed.
So then what we'll do is we'll have to make an amendment to what you guys have read, and they'll say lease transfer is not allowed.
Yeah. That's the easiest way.
Which is kind of like what the original one was.
And if he doesn't want it bad enough, whoever wants to pay the rent, they can lease it instead of him, and we're done.
Right.
Good idea. That's how it should be done.
So, again, we're all in agreement that we're going to strike that and say it's not allowed.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
What else can we vote on?
Well, we can vote on the whole thing with the amendment on there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I guess, should we back up and say... We would like to approve the area lease, the area hangar lease, as printed. Thank you.
The hangar lease approved with the amendment that no somewhere.
Right, but I mean, do we do them together or just do them separately? Okay, so the area hangar lease, do we approve it as it's written? Do I have a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve it as it's written.
Do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. The T hanger. Well,
make a motion to accept it with the clause that said lease transfer not allowed. I don't call it out.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? I gotta grab my right sheet again. February 6th. Okay. I only had that one.
I think we just gave you one, didn't we?
No, that was a T-hanger game.
I only had the one of each.
I don't have the hanger area.
Give them that. Now, it's on the Google Docs, so but that's also why I gave you this for this procedure and then Blue's rules. So now you should have everything.
All right, so the data was since K-2023, which is the data of the Google Docs, so that one is the effective.
Yes, correct. So do we want to change that date on there to be today's date?
All right, I can do that.
Okay. Yeah, so we change that to, that shouldn't change anything for the approval.
So that'll be 2-6.
Okay.
There's a 6 in there.
Yes. New business, none, public comment. Yeah, we talked about that.
Can we back up the lease?
I'm sorry.
What's the status of the lease or primary form?
Bob has the lease for the building, and they're going to have to, they're still finding the one for the fuel farm.
Okay.
Because that's separate, because, you know, it's a separate thing over there. So they'll have to address that. They'll go to Bob for that.
Okay.
Because that is unique with the fuel there as opposed to a normal hangar.
But if that expired in a year or two, do you want,
it's a 50 year.
It's 50?
Yeah. It started in 16. 50-year.
Okay, all right. So they're happy with that?
Yeah. Well, I don't know if Dan's not here, but I'm assuming.
So at 88 Charlie's, they have 4, maybe even 5 hangars. I found the leases for those, and they are just all over the place in terms of gates.
Well, I have them all.
You have them all?
I probably have exactly what you have.
Yeah, okay.
Were they bought after they did the original one?
No, I think they have valid leases for all the numbers that are current in there, but what they might want to do...
They have something I don't have.
Like what?
I mean, they would have a copy of the lease that I don't have.
I just looked at them briefly, and I think they were all signed valid leases, but a couple of them were relatively short-term, and I don't know why, like expiring in 2027. I told them we'd look into,
they
have a choice of keeping that lease or being presented and signing the new one.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, because if they're under that 50-year, I'd stay with that one. But if there are any of them that are coming up short...
There were a couple of those short.
Right. Are you sure that they weren't bought by somebody, which would null and void any of those?
Well, we have all in one file now. I can go up there and look at any time.
Because like I said, I know, like on yours, you bought it so that the original one is not valid and stuff like that. And I can't find mine, which would have been an original one. And you can't find mine. So in lieu of can't finding it, I'm forced to, I'm kind of in the same boat as everybody. So, but I guess those would be something that the manager, now that you've got guidance, you should be able to go through. So you've got rules, you've got guidance, and you've got the FAA stuff. So if they have to present something, I think it'd be fine, right?
Yeah. Does this have to go to the attorney for final?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to send that then to the attorney tomorrow and have him with his final approval. It doesn't have to be voted on. It just, make sure we got our eyes.
And then what timetable to start distributing these new leases?
Chris. For the roll call, we have Chris Lathrop.
Late.
Thanks,
Gary. Tardy.
So, but I mean, that's going to go to the attorney tomorrow, and he'll look it over.
So when can I sign that lease?
Probably, if you give me about 2 weeks. Because I already...
wait a minute, you're talking about some of their lease?
Yes.
I mean, I had, out of all the 88 charters I entered, I don't have any, if they took over a previous lease, but 88 Charlie signed nothing. If they signed something, I don't have it.
And that's what I'm saying, if they took over a previous one, because I don't think they built those. So like Al Vori, if he gave the hangar to 88 Charlie, his lease is not transferable.
I think they all said 88 Charlie, so I'll look at them.
I don't, they better get it to me, because I don't have it. I can tell you.
All right, well. I can't the next 2 days, and maybe we should walk up there and take a look.
What do you want to look at?
See if they're valid leases.
I got a copy. I got to look them up on my computer right now.
Yeah, but you said that what I'm telling you we have may not be the same as what you have.
Oh, so you have the physical copy here somewhere?
At the attorney's hand.
Oh, okay. I'll just see how that's picked up.
Does Al still own his? I mean, I know that was one.
That's the one next to me.
No, the one that's next behind Kitty Corner.
Right behind me is where he used to be.
And he also owns one next to me.
But I know, like, the one that's behind Chris, he had to have bought that. It could not be a lease that's valid.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, I don't know about the rest of them. I just know that one Al was in. Al was given the original one. But now anything after that, they can write 88 Charlie's all day long, but that doesn't mean it's valid. And like the one next to you, they didn't build it. And have they owned it since Don was alive?
I think Al Morey's father built that thing. It's my understanding.
But if it was conveyed over, it says it just can't be conveyed. It has to be.
I know they acquired the T-hanger that's down here, the one with the round top. That was somebody else's prior to.
And that would be another one that would not have a valid. They might write 88 Charlie on it, but it doesn't mean that's valid.
Okay.
What was being done with the leases before I got here is every year when the payment for the lease was due, a sheet was sent out saying this is what's due for this year signed here. That sheet that was returned with a civic signature on the bottom was considered signing. Just having that one sheet. nothing about a lease or anything else. It just said, this lease, I paid. That's all it said. That's it. Nothing.
But that was that land lease for that year of the $200.
No, it was even the T hangers were like that. It didn't read right all the verbiage for the lease. It was only your.
It was an amendment to it. It was just an amendment to make the next payment. That's really.
It was referencing.
It wasn't even an amendment. And the T hangers, everybody that initially rented one, they stole it. So I got the original leases on all those. With the exception of, we have two stores closed. We have an A and a B. Okay, but David Dunn left the left A open. I'm leasing that right now, A. I'm leasing that right as we see. Other than that, everything else is stayed under the same name, and I have that original lease for every team.
Is B available?
Huh?
Is storage area B available?
No, storage area became available, and I grabbed it.
Okay.
But kind of going back to those ones that are conveyed, if they're conveyed, that goes back to what it wasn't ever approved.
Right.
And when they sign that, they're acknowledging that they're paying for that land lease for that previous year, but that doesn't mean that it's the actual lease addendum. Because those leases, the original ones, were for 50 years. But when it's conveyed, it stops being a lease at that point, then you're in month to month. So again, I would think that all three of those we just talked about, 88 does not have a lease on those. They were given. I mean, we're kind of splitting hairs, but I think it's an important hair because you're going to run into a number of them that were, you know, given to something or sold. The sold is easy. But if it's just conveyed, that means the lease doesn't go with the conveyance.
So when I started, instead of sending that out, that's when I started sending an invoice for the amount that was due every year. Basically, what was being sent was an invoice. It didn't say invoice on it, but that's basically all it was.
Because that's really what you're doing. It's an invoice. It's kind of like when you have a trailer park. You're leasing the land underneath it, and you're paying your yearly
lot rent.
Lot rent, and that's what it is here. You're paying your lot rent, and that's why it says, you know, lot, like we're lot, what, 63 or 60?
I'm 62, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm 63, and so we pay that.
But so, it can't be transferred because liability has to be conveyed when you get that lease, the land. And you can't just say, oh, wait, maybe you take it, and then you're still signing for that original lease.
Which is why we put on there that it can't be conveyed.
What is the inception date of the 50-year leases when they first came out?
I was the last one building out here. I was only allotted 25.
You were 25.
Yeah.
But who has 50s?
Prior to that term, because it was after, I believe, they were trying to change the airport here and bring them into the village, and then they were reviewing the leases and they wanted to do 5 years, and the state said you have to do a minimum of 25. That was back to Don, so whenever we had that scenario.
So what we're getting at is, what's the expiration date of the longest term leases here?
I believe it's 35 years.
35 from when?
I'd have to look at it.
But about when?
You mean 35 left?
Huh?
35 left. Expiration.
I don't understand any leases that I saw that were written for 50 years.
I've always heard that 50-year thing, and I was wondering about it.
I think the Palomar Flying Club has a 50-year.
No,
yeah,
I don't have it.
Okay. Well, if Dan was here, because they actually did the research.
What I'm getting at is that I would think that if their leases are expiring in the next 10 years, that most people would be happy to
sign 25.
To get the 25,
right.
Even though there are strings attached that weren't.
Well, even like with 88s, where they might be expiring in a few years, this would give them 25 years. So that would be, then they wouldn't have to worry about it then.
Right.
So, okay.
Yeah, but if they have their existing lease that's still active, right?
Well, you can sign another one.
Yeah, you can supersede it, yep.
And that's what we're doing with some of these.
Redo it.
So you're going to offer it to those folks, and if they decide to take it, then it's more power to them. And like myself, I can't find my lease, so.
And out of all the leases that I had, we had very few leases that have a signature page, that have a date, a letter of lessee's signature, and a lessee's lessor's signature.
So it really, so it really was not fully executed at that point?
It wasn't.
So again, when you talk to the folks, you'll have to kind of convey to them.
Yeah, I don't know where Don put it.
So, okay, we actually went through and approved the leases and the, and.
You added the stormwater and stuff like that?
The stormwater, we added that in there, but that's also under this one, which.
One more thing. When I went through the file boards and there's leases from every year, when I looked at those, all those leases were those years, it was just a payment sheet. Okay, I paid my area lease for this year. That's all it was.
Which is why you changed it to the, just the lot rent, the yearly lot rent for that. So it's not part of the lease, you're not adding to the lease.
That's why I turned it into an invoice. You're just being charged for the property that you're using.
But I think if you have any of that short terms, as far as in years, then that has to be honored.
But it says.
Not for yearly payment.
Not for yearly payment, no, but if you find any of them in there that have signature with the term on it, you know, if.
Out of all of the hangers that we had there, I bet if anything, there couldn't be any more than five, if that.
Yeah.
So all the rest of it would just be more like the invoice, where you just have a signature saying, I paid this.
I know mine had a date on it when I signed it in. Cause I, that was the, what was part of my decision, is how many years it was. I was actually breaking that down versus rent.
So what I've done now to try to straighten that problem out is I have a file full of paper files over here. And what's on paper is also digitized, so it's in a digital file on my computer. I got it in two spots, so I can look back and forth, see where they're, instead of a bunch of paper stapled together for a big file, I just, you can't find anything. So anyway, but I'm just trying to say where, you know, from my end, what it looks like. So, and I think a lot of people that have signed the lease, say they have a signed lease, all they have is that signed sheet to say, I made my lease payment this year. I think that a lot of people think that's a lease contract.
It's not. It's not, no. The other thing that you, I didn't pass out tonight, but we had reviewed is the tie-down leases.
Yeah.
So we're, I think we voted on.
I think that's all fine.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
So we went through the T-hanger, the tie-down, okay. The area lease. We put all those things in.
Yep.
We amended the T-hanger lease to, it can't be sublet.
Okay.
We're discussing that, so we put it in, took it out, put it in. Took
yeah.
It out. So. Okay. I'm looking at the wrong date again.
You should have it like yellow or something.
Yeah. Yeah, look the same. So okay, new business done. Public, yeah, we talked. Set next meeting date.
So that should be a quarter date. Well, do we want to have one before?
Yes, I think we should put one in March sometime.
Okay.
Is there, I'm fine with Mondays, 6:30. Is there a.
6:30 is the earliest that can be.
Right.
I will stand by on a long day for sure, one of those. Let me see if I can figure out.
Chris, is 6:30 too early?
That's about as early as I can get, yeah. I usually work till 6.
Oh.
Mondays.
Which is your day off?
Later
Tuesday. Do we want to switch it? I mean, I'm fine with.
I like that 6:30.
Okay. You want? Can we do it on Tuesdays instead of Monday?
Yeah, that's fine with me.
Can you do
that's
Tuesday?
That's fine. Yeah,
I'm home all day.
You're home on Tuesdays?
Tuesdays and Wednesdays.
It's better for him.
Yeah. Bob, how about you on Tuesdays?
I can't do Tuesdays until after the double day.
So
I'm in a bowling league. It's
not
Tuesday.
Okay. So you'd miss the next one then?
I would miss the next one.
You get the night off, that's fine.
Well, we don't need
Jim will send you a video.
we don't need Bob for a call, so.
No.
No.
Well, he doesn't mind missing the meeting, but.
He'll be fine.
I just try to be here to
he'll,
help out right
here. He'll be fine. He'll be fine.
And then how are you, Luke?
I'm checking the fact that.
Can I just ask a question though?
You sure can.
You sure can.
Is there any reason why the airport manager is not part of the board of the commission? It just seems like it's like having a hand with all the fingers. You know,
Well, the thing was, is when Don was there, is the person who's actually running the airport, if they were part of the decision-making and part of the enforcement, then you kind of have a conflict of interest, because you're the enforcement arm at the airport. And I remember when Don was there, someone said, well, you're making a rule and you're kicking our butts out of it. Whereas if you're part of the solution, I guess,
Well, you're independent.
You're more independent. More so independent. You're supposed to look at the airport as overall.
I understand.
We can give you an honorary
no,
vote.
No, that's all right. I understand. That makes sense to me.
No.
Okay.
I'm pretty good in March except for the 20th.
Okay.
13th?
Yeah, that's what's on Monday. 14th?
Well, 14th is fine too.
Well, the other thing too, Lou, is you're usually accessible. We can usually call you if necessary.
Yeah, I'm usually done working at 5. I'm somewhere, I'm in a hotel.
Unless, of course, you're in the Learjet at 50,000 feet. Hey, Lou, where are you at?
Well, we have Wi-Fi.
Yeah, there you go. we'll get on the WhatsApp for you.
You can do that.
So do we want to do the 14th of March at 6:30?
Yep.
Okay for me.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Okay. So.
Who made that motion?
I made the motion. I so moved the next
I'll
meeting.
Second it.
Be
March. Okay.
I'll second it.
Do we have a motion to adjourn?
I so moved.
Okay.
I'll second it.
Opposed or all in favor?
Second it. Aye.
Opposed? Okay.
Well, we're supposed to stay here.
Well, you know I won't be here on that day.